An airport is an aerodrome with facilities for flights to take off and land. Airports often have facilities to store and maintain aircraft and a control tower. An airport consists of a landing area, which comprises an aerially accessible open space including at least one operationally active surface such as a runway for a plane to take off or a helipad, and often includes adjacent utility buildings such as control towers, hangars and terminals. Larger airports may have fixed base operator services, airport aprons, taxiway bridges, air traffic control centers, passenger facilities such as restaurants and lounges, and emergency services. An airport with a helipad for rotorcraft but no runway is called a heliport. An airport for use by seaplanes and amphibious aircraft is called a seaplane base. Such a base typically includes a stretch of open water for takeoffs and landings, and seaplane docks for tying up. An international airport has additional facilities for customs and passport control. In warfare, airports can become a focus of intense fighting. For example, the Battle of Tripoli Airport or the Battle for Donetsk Airport, both taking place in 2014. An airport primarily for military use is called an airbase or air station. Most of the world's airports are owned by local, regional, or national government bodies. Landside and airside areas. Airports are divided into landside and airside. Landside includes parking lots, public transport, railway stations and access roads. Airside includes all areas accessible to aircraft including runways, taxiways and ramps. Passage between landside and airside is tightly controlled at all airports. To access airside, one must go through security and, if applicable, passport control too. This applies to everyone, including staff. Most major airports provide commercial outlets for products and services. Airports may also contain premium and VIP services. The premium and VIP services may include express check-in and dedicated check-in counters. In addition to people, airports move cargo around the clock. Many large airports are located near railway trunk routes. Air traffic control presence. The majority of the world's airports are non-towered, with no air traffic control presence. Busy airports have air traffic control, ATC, system. All airports use a traffic pattern to assure smooth traffic flow between departing and arriving aircraft. There are a number of aids available to pilots, though not all airports are equipped with them. Many airports have lighting that help guide planes using the runways and taxiways at night or in rain, snow, or fog. In the US and Canada, the vast majority of airports, large and small, will either have some form of automated airport weather station, a human observer, or a combination of the two. Air safety is an important concern in the operation of an airport, and airports often have their own safety services. Terminology. The terms aerodrome, airfield, and airstrip may also be used to refer to airports, and the terms heliport, seaplane base, and stallport refer to airports dedicated exclusively to helicopters, seaplanes, or short takeoff and landing aircraft. In colloquial use, the terms airport and aerodrome are often interchanged. However, in general, the term airport may imply or confer a certain stature upon the aviation facility that an aerodrome may not have achieved. In some jurisdictions, airport is a legal term of art reserved exclusively for those aerodromes certified or licensed as airports by the relevant National Aviation Authority after meeting specified certification criteria or regulatory requirements. That is to say, all airports are aerodromes, but not all aerodromes are airports. In jurisdictions where there is no legal distinction between aerodrome and airport, which term to use in the name of an aerodrome may be a commercial decision. Aerodrome is uncommon in the United States. Infrastructure. Smaller or less developed airports which represent the vast majority, often have a single runway shorter than 1,000 meters, 3,300 feet. Larger airports for airline flights generally have paved runways 2,000 meters, 6,600 feet, or longer. Many small airports have dirt, grass, or gravel runways, rather than asphalt or concrete. In the United States, the minimum dimensions for dry, hard landing fields are defined by the FAR landing and takeoff field lengths. These include considerations for safety margins during landing and takeoff. Heavier aircraft require longer runways. The longest public use runway in the world is at Kandu Bangda Airport in China. It has a length of 5,500 meters, 18,045 feet. The world's widest paved runway is at Ulyanovsk-Vostochny Airport in Russia and is 105 meters, 344 feet wide. As of 2009, the CIA stated that there were approximately 44,000 airports or airfields recognizable from the air around the world, including 15,095 in the US, the US having the most in the world. Airport ownership and operation. The Berlin Brandenburg Airport is publicly financed by the states of Berlin and Brandenburg in the Federal Republic of Germany. Most of the world's airports are owned by local, regional, or national government bodies who then lease the airport to private corporations who oversee the airport's operation. For example, in the United Kingdom, the state-owned British Airports Authority originally operated 8 of the nation's major commercial airports. It was subsequently privatized in the late 1980s. And following its takeover by the Spanish Ferrovial Consortium in 2006, has been further divested and downsized to operating just Heathrow now. Germany's Frankfurt Airport is managed by the quasi-private firm Fraport, while in India GMR Group operates through joint ventures. Indira Gandhi International Airport and Rajiv Gandhi International Airport, Bengaluru International Airport and Chhatrapati Shivaji International Airport are controlled by GVK Group. The rest of India's airports are managed by the Airports Authority of India. In the United States, commercial airports are generally operated directly by government entities or government-created airport authorities, also known as port authorities, such as the Los Angeles World Airports Authority that oversees several airports in the Greater Los Angeles area, including Los Angeles International Airport. In Canada, the federal authority, Transport Canada, divested itself of all but the remotest airports in 1999-2000. Now most airports in Canada are owned and operated by individual legal authorities or are municipally owned. Many U.S. airports still lease part or all of their facilities to outside firms, who operate functions such as retail management and parking. In the U.S., all commercial airport runways are certified by the FAA under the Code of Federal Regulations, Title 14, Part 139. Certification of commercial service airports, but maintained by the local airport under the regulatory authority of the FAA. Despite the reluctance to privatize airports in the U.S., despite the FAA sponsoring a privatization program since 1996, the government-owned, contractor-operated GOCO arrangement is the standard for the operation of commercial airports in the rest of the world. Airport structures. Airports are divided into landside and airside areas. Landside areas include parking lots, public transportation, train stations, and access roads. Airside areas include all areas accessible to aircraft, including runways, taxiways, and aprons. Access from landside areas to airside areas is tightly controlled at most airports. Passengers on commercial flights access airside areas through terminals where they can purchase tickets, clear security check, or claim luggage and board aircraft through gates. The waiting areas which provide passenger access to aircraft are typically called concourses. Although this term is often used interchangeably with terminal, the area where aircraft park next to a terminal to load passengers and baggage is known as a ramp, or incorrectly, the tarmac. Parking areas for aircraft away from terminals are called aprons. Airports can be towered or non-towered, depending on air traffic density and available funds. Due to their high capacity and busy airspace, many international airports have air traffic control located on site. Airports with international flights have customs and immigration facilities. However, as some countries have agreements that allow travel between them without customs and immigrations, such facilities are not a definitive need for an international airport. International flights often require a higher level of physical security, although in recent years, many countries have adopted the same level of security for international and domestic travel. Some airport structures include on-site hotels built within or attached to a terminal building. Airport hotels have grown popular due to their convenience for transient passengers and easy accessibility to the airport terminal. Many airport hotels also have agreements with airlines to provide overnight lodging for displaced passengers. Products and services. Most major airports provide commercial outlets for products and services. Most of these companies, many of which are internationally known brands, are located within the departure areas. These include clothing boutiques and restaurants. Prices charged for items sold at these outlets are generally higher than those outside the airport. However, some airports now regulate costs to keep them comparable to street prices. This term is misleading, as prices often match the manufacturer's suggested retail price, MSRP, but are almost never discounted. Apart from major fast food chains, some airport restaurants offer regional cuisine specialties for those in transit so that they may sample local food and culture without leaving the airport. Major airports in such countries as Russia and Japan offer miniature sleeping units within the airport that are available for rent by the hour. The smallest type is the capsule hotel, popular in Japan. A slightly larger variety is known as a sleep box. An even larger type is provided by the company Yotel. Premium and VIP services. Airports may also contain premium and VIP services. The premium and VIP services may include express check-in and dedicated check-in counters. These services are usually reserved for first and business class passengers, premium frequent flyers, and members of the airline's clubs. Premium services may sometimes be open to passengers who are members of a different airline's frequent flyer program. This can sometimes be part of a reciprocal deal, as when multiple airlines are part of the same alliance, or as a ploy to attract premium customers away from rival airlines. Sometimes these premium services will be offered to a non-premium passenger if the airline has made a mistake in handling of the passenger, such as unreasonable delays or mishandling of checked baggage. Airline lounges frequently offer free or reduced-cost food, as well as alcoholic and non-alcoholic beverages. Lounges themselves typically have seating, showers, quiet areas, televisions, computer, Wi-Fi and internet access, and power outlets that passengers may use for their electronic equipment. Some airline lounges employ baristas, bartenders and gourmet chefs. Airlines sometimes operate multiple lounges within the one airport terminal, allowing ultra-premium customers, such as first-class customers, additional services, which are not available to other premium customers. Multiple lounges may also prevent overcrowding of the lounge facilities. Cargo and freight services. In addition to people, airports move cargo around the clock. Cargo airlines often have their own on-site and adjacent infrastructure to transfer parcels between ground and air. Cargo terminal facilities are areas where international airports export cargo has to be stored after customs clearance and prior to loading on the aircraft. Similarly, import cargo that is offloaded needs to be in bond before the consignee decides to take delivery. Areas have to be kept aside for examination of export and import cargo by the airport authorities. Designated areas of sheds may be given to airlines and freight forwarding agencies. Every cargo terminal has a land side and an air side. The land side is where the exporters and importers, through either their agents or by themselves, deliver or collect shipments, while the air side is where loads are moved to or from the aircraft. In addition, cargo terminals are divided into distinct areas: export, import and interliner transshipment support services, Recife International Airport in Recife, Brazil. Aircraft and passenger boarding bridges maintenance, pilot operations, commissioning, training services, aircraft rental, and hangar rental are most often performed by a fixed base operator, FBO. At major airports, particularly those used as hubs, airlines may operate their own support facilities. Some airports, typically military air bases, have long runways used as emergency landing sites. Many air bases have arresting equipment for fast aircraft known as arresting gear, a strong cable suspended just above the runway and attached to a hydraulic reduction gear mechanism. Together with the landing aircraft's arresting hook, it is used in situations where the aircraft's brakes would be insufficient by themselves. In the United States, many larger civilian airports also host an Air National Guard base. Airport access. Many large airports are located near railway trunk routes for seamless connection of multimodal transport. For instance, Frankfurt Airport, Amsterdam Airport Schiphol, London Heathrow Airport, London Gatwick Airport, and London Stansted Airport. It is also common to connect an airport and a city with rapid transit, light rail lines or other non-road public transport systems. Some examples of this would include the AirTrain JFK at John F. Kennedy International Airport in New York, Link Light Rail that runs from the heart of downtown Seattle to Seattle-Tacoma International Airport, and the Silver Line T at Boston's Logan International Airport by the Massachusetts Bay Transportation Authority, MBTA. Such a connection lowers risk of missed flights due to traffic congestion. Large airports usually have access also through controlled access highways, freeways or motorways, from which motor vehicles enter either the departure loop or the arrival loop. Internal transport. The distances passengers need to move within a large airport can be substantial. It is common for airports to provide moving walkways and buses. The Hartsfield-Jackson Atlanta International Airport has a tram that takes people through the concourses and baggage claim. Major airports with more than one terminal offer interterminal transportation, such as Mexico City International Airport, where the domestic building of Terminal 1 is connected by aerotrain to Terminal 2 on the other side of the airport. History and development. The earliest aircraft takeoff and landing sites were grassy fields. The plane could approach at any angle that provided a favorable wind direction. A slight improvement was the dirt-only field, which eliminated the drag from grass. However, these only functioned well in dry conditions. Later, concrete surfaces would allow landings, rain or shine, day or night. The title of world's oldest airport is disputed, but College Park Airport in Maryland, U.S., established in 1909 by Wilbur Wright, is generally agreed to be the world's oldest continually operating airfield, although it serves only general aviation traffic. Bisbee Douglas International Airport in Arizona was declared the first international airport of the Americas by U.S. President Franklin D. Roosevelt in 1943. Pearson Field Airport in Vancouver, Washington had a dirigible land in 1905 and planes in 1911 and is still in use. Brayman Airport opened in 1913 and remains in use. Although it served as an American military field between 1945 and 1949, Amsterdam Airport Schiphol opened on September 16, 1916 as a military airfield, but only accepted civil aircraft from December 17, 1920, allowing Sydney Airport in Sydney, Australia, which started operations in January 1920, to claim to be one of the world's oldest continually operating commercial airports. Minneapolis-St. Paul International Airport in Minneapolis-St. Paul, Minnesota, opened in 1920 and has been in continuous commercial service since. It serves about 35 million passengers each year and continues to expand, recently opening a new 11,000-foot, 3,355-meter runway. Of the airports constructed during this early period in aviation, it is one of the largest and busiest that is still currently operating. Rome Ciampino Airport, opened 1916, is also a contender, as well as the Don Muang International Airport near Bangkok, Thailand, which opened in 1914. Increased aircraft traffic during World War I led to the construction of landing fields. Aircraft had to approach these from certain directions, and this led to the development of aids for directing the approach and landing slope. Following the war, some of these military airfields added civil facilities for handling passenger traffic. One of the earliest such fields was Paris, Le Bourget Airport at Le Bourget, near Paris.